So to the topic of the day, Mr. President, for the past few days, we've been working on this legislation to reauthorize the Federal Aviation Administration. Chairman Thune of the Commerce Committee has been, and his staff have been doing some good work, making a lot of progress toward completing the bill. And I hope that that cooperation continues and we are able to conclude this legislation tomorrow. But this legislation would do some very important things. It would streamline critical new investments in an airport infrastructure and aviation safety to protect passengers and to help them get where they need to go more efficiently. It would also include the most comprehensive airline security reform since President Obama took office. For example, it strengthens the vetting process for airport employees and addresses a growing number of cybersecurity threats facing aviation and air navigation systems. And most importantly of all, it puts American consumers and safety first. And it does so without raising taxes or adding fees to customers, which feel like a tax. You may call it a fee, but if it costs money, it really doesn't feel any different than a tax. But I'd also like to point out the benefits to states like mine, Texas. It protects air traffic partnerships that support dozens of Texas airports and directly responds to requests that I've gotten from Texas communities looking for new opportunities to improve regional air traffic management or expand service in order to meet demand. All crucial measures to help Texas communities move people and goods safely through airports. I've introduced an amendment to this legislation with the two Arizona senators and our junior senator colleague from Nevada, Senator Heller, that would do even more to help our ports of entry by strengthening public-private partnerships at air, land, and seaports. The fact of the matter is, financial resources, money, is always in short supply. And rather than always coming back to the taxpayer and saying, you need to pay more, what we need to do is become more creative. And that's why public-private partnerships are important. Local communities are willing to join in a partnership with the federal government to deal with these critical infrastructure needs at land, air, and seaports, and that's what this amendment would do. We've already seen in my state, time and time again, how important these partnerships can be to help reduce wait times at ports of entry, the land-based ports of entry like Laredo, which is the largest land-based port of entry in the United States. And if you've ever been there, you see the trucks stacked up coming from Mexico and the important trade that goes on between our two countries that supports 6 million jobs in the United States alone. But these public-private partnerships have been very successful in helping deal with our infrastructure needs. It's not just about convenience. It has an economic impact as well. I mentioned the 6 million people who benefit because of their jobs depend on binational trade just between the United States and Mexico. For example, according to one study, each minute a truck sits idle at the border waiting to come to the United States, even though they are legally authorized to come here to bring goods manufactured or produced in Mexico, for example, more than $100 million in economic output is lost or forfeited. Let me say that again. For every minute a truck sits at the border, because we don't have the infrastructure to process the truck into the United States, more than $100 million in economic output is lost or forfeited. So this amendment would authorize more of these partnerships, which would also facilitate staffing and better help protect legitimate trade and travel and keep our economy running smoothly and keep jobs being created. So I hope my colleagues will consider this amendment and vote to build on the success of similar programs in the past, both in Texas and across the country. I want to mention one last amendment, one I introduced yesterday as well, that would target the world's foremost sponsor of terrorism. That's the country of Iran. Mehan Air is Iran's largest commercial airline, and it has repeatedly played a role in exporting Iran's terrorism. We all know Iran as being the number one state sponsor of international terrorism, and Mehan Air is one of the ways that they export that terrorism. We might call Mehan Air Terrorist Airways, would perhaps be more precise. It not only supports the efforts of the Quds Force, a special unit of Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard, but on another Iranian-backed terrorist group, Hezbollah. To put it simply, Mehan Air enables the reach of Iranian personnel and weapons throughout the Middle East, as well as Iran's proxies, as the regime continues unabated to undercut the interests of the United States and our allies in the Middle East, like Israel. Unfortunately, today, Mehan Air is working to expand its international operations now that the Obama administration has lifted sanctions as part of the misguided Iran nuclear deal. And so Mehan Air is expanding its operations and adding more international airports to its flight patterns, including several in Europe, in an effort to, of course, increase its bottom line. Mehan Air's unfettered support of terrorism and the worst aspects of the Iranian regime should give us all pause. And I'm concerned about the security risks of Americans who fly in and out of the same airport serviced by a Mehan Airlines aircraft. So my amendment would require the Department of Homeland Security to compile and make public a list of airports where Mehan Air has recently landed. I think the public has a right to know that the airports they're flying into are being used to service an airline of the Iranian government used to export terrorism. And so it would also require the Department of Homeland Security to assess what added security measures are needed. We must protect our country and our citizens from an airline that is complicit in terrorist activity. So I hope my colleagues will join me in supporting this common sense amendment to the FAA reauthorization bill to help shine a light on this bad actor. Mr. President, I would just close with this. Under new leadership, the 114th Congress has actually gotten the Senate back to work again. And it's not just for the benefit of the majority party. It's not just for the benefit of the minority party. It's actually for the benefit of the constituents that we serve, because they're the ones who benefit when we can try to work and find common ground and move legislation forward where we can find agreement, knowing that there are many areas where we will never find agreement because of fundamental principled differences of opinion. But this is another example of an important piece of legislation that will benefit the entire country. That definitely isn't a partisan piece of legislation, so it's something I'm glad that we've been able to move forward on, and I look forward to concluding this legislation tomorrow. It's time we upgrade our air transportation system for the entire country, and it's time to put the safety of airline customers first, and this bill does that.